Today afternoon, President Yoweri Museveni, accompanied by the First Lady Janet Kataha Museveni, received a warm welcome in Chankwanzi, where he summoned the NRM members of parliament for the 10 days retreat. On arrival, the president was received by the Vice President Jessica Alupo, the Prime Minister Robin Nabanja, the NRM Secretary General Richard Todong, ministers, and the government chief whip Hamson Oboa. Speaking to legislators, the president first explained to the country the loopholes that might have led the Al-Shabaab terrorists to carry out a deadly attack on the Ugandan troops in Somalia. He insisted that there are internal weaknesses within the army which they're going to look into, but the Al-Shabaabs will have to pay for the pain they caused to the Ugandan troops.
The attack started at what you call in your English way, 10 past 5, when it was still dark. Now, if people are not well prepared, fighting in the dark can also be another problem. They can just panic for no reason. And yet, there is a way we fight in the dark, it's a well-known way. But Al-Shabaab will pay.
General Museveni explained why he summoned members for the 10-day retreat.
What I want to talk to you about is ideological, strategic, policy and implementation cohesion, those four words, and administrative cohesion. The NRM, as Brigadier Kisembo was saying, started as a student movement in the 1960s.
Earlier, the Vice President Jessica Alupo commended the NRM legislators for having heeded to the President's call and turned up in big numbers for the retreat. She noted that the retreat will enable them to upgrade their leadership skills.
So far, the interaction we have had, even from Parliament, they understand very fully the four principles of NRM, including nationalism. That means, Your Excellency, the members you are going to address here are very patriotic and nationalistic. Pan-Africanism, Your Excellency, the members you are going to address understand fully the principle Pan-Africanism. Socio-economic transformation, Your Excellency, the members also fully comprehend, and also democracy. So, Your Excellency, I have seen the topics which we are going to be taken through, and I highly believe that they will enhance us as NRM leaders.
Legislators emphasize that the retreat came in timely, and they're optimistic that a lot to do with the functionality of the country will be discussed and dealt with, especially economic transformation, job creation, fighting poverty, and wealth creation.
Already benefiting from these programs, especially Emioga, we have very many success stories from the youth leaders circle, but we still have a challenge with the parish development model. Now, as leaders from the NRM, we negotiated with government to gazette 30% of the PDM funds for the youth, which was done. But the challenge is that it was done on paper and it's not being implemented on ground because young people lack representation on the SACCO leadership. So that's one of the issues that we are going to be advocating for here.
This retreat, we as the members of the NRM caucus, would like to discuss with the party chairman and His Excellency the President matters relating to, one, socio-economic transformation, job creation, as well as wealth creation among SR people.
The Secretary General of the NRM Party, Richard Todong, noted that the retreat will greatly help them to do proper evaluation as the party for the 2 years they have already covered in this term of office.
Have this kind of retreats mid-term of our administration. So we have already done 2 years in leadership, so it's proper that we come and evaluate ourselves, evaluate our programs and our policies, and see how we have been able to implement them, where we've been finding challenges and how we can correct those challenges, and how we can respond a little more effectively to the public's concern.
MPs expect the retreat to address issues of internal rift within the NRM party. Report compiled by Jaliat Namuwaya for the news.